Hi there, my name is Marijke de Jong, founder of the Straightness Training Academy, and so cool that many of you took the survey this week. Thanks so much, and in a minute I will share with you the results. Now, in this video I will also share with you the number one thing that will give you the biggest boost in your personal development as a straightness trainer. Before I'll dive into that, let me show you some results. One of the questions was, when it comes to your most challenging horse, what is the main issue? Is it a physical restriction because of an injury, or is it physical imbalance because of the natural asymmetry? Is it a behavioral imbalance in the category fight issue, or is it a flight issue, or is it lack of understanding where your horse doesn't understand what you want, or you don't know how to teach your horse new things, or is it lack of motivation where it feels like your horse is uninterested in you or the work and lazy or bored? Or do you have none of these issues? Now, 751 people responded to the survey, and 7% of this group has none of these issues, and that's 45 people. But 93% of this group experienced some kind of challenge with their horse. Now, as the survey shows, 9% is dealing with a physical restriction, and with 30%, the main issue is physical imbalance, so the horse is a bit crooked or asymmetrical in body and limbs, and therefore he's falling on the inside shoulder or over the outside shoulder, or he's not distributing the weight equally over all four legs. But the majority, that's 54 of the people, the majority is dealing with some kind of behavioral or mental issue. So 10% of the people say there's a bit lack of mutual understanding, and 9% experiences lack of motivation in their horse. And 35% of the people are dealing with a behavioral imbalance on the continuum of fight and flight. Let's say the balance is in the middle, but 23% of the people are dealing with a horse that is more or less flight oriented. So this horse is a bit sensitive, shy, alert, or easily worried, nervous, hesitant, or insecure. And when things get more extreme, this horse becomes more spooky and jumpy, or even upset and stressed. Now, 12% of the people are dealing with a horse that is more or less fight oriented, and this horse can be a bit pushy or edgy, or even a bit mouthy and nippy, or grabbing the reins, or grumpy and annoyed. And when things get extreme, he might bite, rear, strike, or kick. Now, the horse's ears will tell us more about the state he's in. And I know that many people think that a happy horse always has both ears pointing forward, but when training a balanced horse, his ears will be much more in a so-called focus mode. So his ears will move from one ear forward to two ears more backwards. And two ears backwards is often seen in riding, which is a sign of concentration on the rider. And when we work from the ground, the inside ear will point towards you as a sign of focusing on your communication. But when the horse is getting distracted, he's losing his focus on you and he's getting more alert. And you can see that because two ears are going to point forward in the direction of the distraction. And the more tensed the ears are pinned forward, the more he gets worried, losing his calm, so he starts to move, and when he gets more extreme, he becomes spooky, jumpy, nervy, just trying to escape and flee from the situation. But when he can't flee, he might get you into trouble with defensive behavior, like pulling on the rein or rope or rearing. Now, if you have a more fight-oriented horse, he'll be more on the left side of the continuum. And then when he doesn't like the situation, when he's getting a bit annoyed, then he'll pin his ears a bit more backwards. And when he really gets angry, he might pin his ears totally flat. And the next thing is that he'll bite or kick. So we need to find ways to keep our horse out of the extremes and in balance. And to get there, we need a horse that understands us and is motivated to work with us. And straightness training will help you with that. So back to the survey. So 54% of the people are facing mental and emotional challenges, and 39% of the people are dealing with physical challenges. So there you are. You'd like to train your horse, but like many riders with you, you are facing one of these challenges. So you're experiencing a gap between where you are right now and where you want to be with your horse. And that's probably the reason why you're interested in straightness training, just to find ways to help your horse with his physical, mental, emotional, or spiritual health, and to increase his overall well-being in body, mind, heart, and soul. But as the survey shows, one of the questions was which best describes your current level of skill when it comes to straightness training. Now, 59 of the participants say they have a novice level of skill, and 24% say they have an elementary level of skill. So that's 83% in total who don't feel they are competent, advanced, or excellent when it comes to improving a horse's balance. And when it comes to the current level of confidence, only 11% is confident about what they are doing, knowing where to start, what to do next in any given situation. So there you are, not feeling completely competent and not feeling completely confident, not feeling certain about where to start or what to do next. And at times you feel stuck or challenged, not knowing how to turn things around and how to break through current obstacles. Or you can't get from just good to amazing. And I know how you feel. I've been there too, and many fellow students with you. Now, ultimately, what we really ask ourselves is, how do I know it's right? How do I know that what I feel is in line with how it should look? How can I be sure that I'm doing the right thing? Well, you're not the only one who has these questions. And the answer is, we all need feedback. We need to evaluate our work if we want to progress. Now, we can evaluate our work in three ways. The first way is the way most of you use, and that is using your own personal experience. This way we also used when we learned to walk as a young child, and this is how it works. First, you define what you want, you set a goal. You want to learn to stand on your own feet, so you take action and start practicing. Along the way, you recognize what's working and what's not working, so you generate your own feedback. Then you keep what's working and you are flexible to change your approach when it's not working. And repeat this until you get what you want and reach your desired outcome. Now, since we can all walk now, it's proof that this way of using feedback from the inside out is a pretty powerful way. But it could be difficult to generate your own feedback when it comes to doing straightness training. Because whilst doing both the execution as the evaluation at the same time, and when you're close to the horse or riding him, you can't see the whole horse and you can't see the bigger picture, so you are in a way limited in your observation. Therefore, you are limited in the evaluation of the whole situation. And the second limitation may be that you're observing from your own level of knowledge, so you can only give meaning to the situation based on the knowledge framework you have. And when you are new to straightness training, that could be of a whole other level and perhaps much lower level than the level of someone who is very experienced. So therefore, there's a second way, which is feedback from somebody else. Then you ask someone more experienced and knowledgeable than you to evaluate you. And during a practical lesson with an instructor, this instructor can observe you. And in this process, he has a visual input about what you feel. And from this point of view, he'll say, "Yes, that looks fine. Can you feel it?" And this way you can anchor this feeling that it's the right feeling and that what you're doing is the right thing. So you'll get feedback in the moment. You'll get feedback about what you do and about what and how you should do things differently. And then with this feedback, you try to change your approach to make things better. Now, this is a verbal way of getting feedback from the outside in, where you hear what you should do differently at the exact moment. Now, a drawback is that during the lesson you have to hear and adjust at the same time, so that's in a way kind of sensory multitasking. However, a lot of times, the moment you start doing and feeling, you stop hearing, because we'd like to think we can multitask, but actually we are not that good in processing two things at the same time. So when your instructor speaks to you during a lesson, most of the time you'll hear only 20% of what he's saying, and this could be a bit more, but it's definitely far from 100% because you're so busy with your horse, or because you're in a certain mood or state, like being nervous, or you lose your concentration because of your horse's reaction and interaction, or you're getting tired at the end of the lesson, so you can't absorb all information at once. So then when you come home and start to digest your lesson, you have to tap into your memories. And then you remember, for example, that your instructor said three things, but you can only remember two. Or sometimes you can't remember what exactly has been said. So the tap into the memory is limited. Therefore, we also need a third way. The third powerful way to get feedback is to film yourself. And this way you can rewind to the past so that you can learn from it. You stop time and then you go back a few minutes, a few hours, weeks, months, years. You just travel in time and look at yourself performing. It's almost like science fiction, Back to the Future. It's incredible that we have this time machine called video. So we are able to film our performance, to rewind it, to look at ourselves in the past from a distance, from a third person's perspective, so you see the bigger picture. It's super useful. In the last 2 years, I discovered that the one thing that caused the biggest boost and biggest breakthroughs for strength training students is that they started to film themselves. Many students told me that that was the best thing ever. It made the biggest shift. Just to be able to see yourself from a third person's perspective is very revealing. Now, an even more powerful strategy for getting feedback is to combine those three ways. So you prepare yourself for every lesson. This way you'll discover your holes and missing links, so you know what you want to learn. Then you go to your teacher, so you get help in figuring out how to close the gap. And thanks to his feedback, you do. And you make sure you video the lesson, so you also have access to the 80% you miss during the actual lesson. Bam! Super powerful! And that's my biggest tip today. Start filming yourself and make sure to always film your lessons. This way you freeze your lesson and you can melt it and redigest pieces of it whenever you want and whenever you need it. And this way you'll get 100% value out of that same lesson over and over again. Now, I know that it may be hard to look at yourself because most of us are perfectionists. But let me tell you this, the desire for perfection is your worst enemy. The ambition for perfection is the biggest way to not achieve perfection. So don't be crippled by perfection and just decide to value progression over perfection. And then a whole new world is out there waiting for you, which can lead to multiple breakthroughs and exponential improvement for you and your horse. Now, another problem is, what if there's no instructor available or nearby? Now, of course, you can learn loads from your own videos, but we've already seen the importance of having a schooled eye to tweak important details. So what if there's no one more experienced around to give you feedback? Now, in the survey, I asked, if you have no direct and instant access to an ST instructor, what kind of feedback would support you best? Now, 70% would rely on personal experience, 10% prefer feedback from a friend, 19% would ask for support in one of our Straightness Training Facebook groups, 4% would like to ask me a question during our live webinar, And 8% is willing to travel far and even abroad to receive a practical lesson and feedback from an ST instructor. But 42% of you ticked that you would like to have feedback from my team of ST evaluators on a video of you and your horse. Well, the good news is there's a new structured process which includes online coaching and feedback through video lessons, specially designed for people just like you, who want to close the gap between where you are and where you want to be, to bring back the juice to your training, and for people who want to learn and accomplish new things and connect deeply with their horse. It's for people who'd like to experience a sense of growth and improvement, and it fits perfectly if you want to optimize your skills and maximize your horse's potential so you can make a positive difference for your horse and contribute to your horse's well-being. You know, we're always busy with how to get maximum progression with our students, so we developed a detailed, complete and structured mastery program that includes step-by-step coaching and personal feedback for our students. Now, already in 2014, we opened the doors to the ST Academy with the structured mastery and evaluation program, which is our online video evaluation system. And with this system and my team of ST evaluators, we can give you feedback on your work and help you improve wherever you are in the world. And both programs are the pathway to master straightness training all the way up to the highest levels, and for some also the pathway in becoming an ST instructor. Now, already over 1,000 mastery students jumped on board. However, it appears to be a big step for students to dive into the complete mastery program and fully integrated and structured academy. We do know that some of you would love to be part of this academy, but that you also have some doubts, hesitation, reluctance, or challenges. As you can see in the survey, a big issue is lack of time. Only 3% of the people can focus full time on their passion, the horses. But the majority of the people have only a couple of hours a day available, or even less. But your wish is our command, and especially for people who have not that many hours and resources available, we significantly lowered the threshold of entering the academy by reducing time and funds, and we did so by creating the brand new Straightness Training Mastery Entry Course. This means that the entry course requires less time, less funds, and besides that, it has a clear and graduated structure, so you can go step by step through a series of lessons, and you can take it one step at a time, all at your own pace, at a time that suits you best. The Straightness Training Entry Course is meant to be a stepping stone into Straightness Training Mastery and the Evaluation Program. The course covers the most fundamental and critical training component, which is groundwork, and will go through the basic and advanced exercises in an in-depth and consistent and structured way, so it's easy to learn. And I'm right behind you in this course, together with my team of evaluators, and we give personal feedback on your work so you get the attention and coaching you deserve. Plus, once you enrolled, you'll be a full member of the Straightness Training Academy and you'll be a mastery student. So with the entry course, you'll get a taste of mastery, but you don't have to eat the whole elephant. We'll start to eat the first part and we'll master groundwork. And then you can decide yourself when it's time to master the other training pillars. And of course, it would be really great if some of you continue after that and become a straightness training instructor one day. But first, we'd love you to get started with the Straightness Training Mastery Entry Course and take a look at it. If you would click on the button below this video, you can see exactly what the entry course is about and how you can join the Straightness Training Academy as a mastery student today. Regardless, I wish you and your horse the best of luck in the future. Thanks so much for watching this video.